In this video, we'll be talking about corporate social responsibility and corporate social investment. Particularly in this video, we'll be concentrating on the differences between the two. But the only question when you're writing examination, where you'll be expected to differentiate, that's the only time you'll be expected to differentiate between corporate social responsibility and corporate social investment. Now, when we talk about corporate social responsibility, remember the previous video that we have done, we've talked about corporate social responsibility. It's an ethical way, it's an obligation that is made by the businesses to plow back to the community. Remember, the business cannot be sustained, the business cannot live without community. It is dependent on the community, so that the community must come and buy this product from the business. So that is why the business will be sustained. So now, or corporate social responsibility is when the business have to take care of this community, come up with the project, come up with the things that will uplift this community. Corporate social responsibility, it can be used as a marketing strategy, it can promote the image of the business, it can promote the interest of the stakeholders. Now, when we talk about stakeholders, we are talking about all the personnel, all the people who are involved in that particular business. It could be the shareholders, the customers, the workers, everyone who's involved in that business context. We call those stakeholders. Now, when we talk about corporate social investment, we are talking about the project that are initiated by this business. They will come up with what type of the project that will uplift the community. It could be the project to uplift the skill of the community, come up with project for bettering the standard of living of this community. You know, we've got different projects that we'll be talking about when we talk about corporate social investment. So now let us talk about the purpose of corporate social responsibility. Purpose of corporate social responsibility, it is aimed at creating the safe working environment. It's a responsibility of the business to ensure that the workers are safe in a working environment. And the second point, these programs that are initiated by this business, they have to be programs that are internal programs that the business used to call, they need to be ethical project, comply with law. They mustn't come up with a project that are illegal. For example, come up with a project that will employ younger children, younger than 15. That's not acceptable. They have to do projects that are ethically correct. And the third point, the business need to promote the public interest. Do away with a harmful project, or do away with the project, or the project that will exhaust all the natural resources of the community. They need to come up with a project that will take care of the interest of the public. And the other point, the fourth point, is that the business operation need to address a triple bottom line. You remember the previous video that you've watched, we've talked about three P's. The first P is for people, planet, profit. When you are doing this project, you need to focus again on these three P's. If you are not clear about it, please watch the previous video where I explain three P, triple bottom line. And the other purpose that we are going to talk about, these key areas of the project supposed to be environmental friendly. You need not to come with a project that are going to harm. Maybe during your production process or the project that you'll be doing, it must not harm the environment, pollute air, or maybe you go to dump things on rivers or whatever. You need to take care of the environment. And those are the purpose of corporate social responsibility. And then we've got the components of corporate social responsibility.
What is that?
When we talk about the components, we are talking about when you are going to do this project, what is it that you can focus on? You are going to think of environment. You are going to think of ethical corporate social investment. Ethical, you need to correct things. Ethically, things are things that are allowed by law. Unethical are things that are not. You are not going to advertise wrong. You are not going to, you know, those are the ethical corporate investment. And then you need to think about the health and safety of your workers. You need to think about corporate governance, the laws of your business. You need to think about business ethics. You need to think about employment equity. Equity, you remember, equal people should be treated equally in a working environment. We are going to think of a supply chain or distribution channel. When we talk about supply chain or distribution channel, we are talking about the process, the journey. When we are producing a product, let's take, for example, we are manufacturing this water. Now, firstly, it will start from the manufacturers. From manufacturers, it will go to the wholesalers. Then what was the purpose of the wholesalers? Wholesalers, they do what? They pack, they put this product on bigger benches. And what do? They transport to the retailers. The retailers, what do? They place an order to the wholesalers. Therefore, the wholesalers, they transport to the retailers. And what is the purpose of the retailers? To sell to the customers. Retailers are the shops, like it could be Click, Speak and Pay, whatever. Those are the retailers. And the last person on chain of distribution are the customers. Customers, the people who are going to buy, people who are going to make sure that the enterprise, it is sustained. That is a channel of distribution, that what I'm explaining now. The other component, we think of the employees and the customers, and we think of the community. We were talking about the components of corporate social responsibilities. And now I would like us to talk about the impact. Now, since we've got corporate social responsibility and corporate social investment, you are not going to be asked the impact of corporate social investment or the impact of corporate social responsibility. It's the same. It doesn't matter whether you'll be talking about corporate social responsibility or you'll be talking about corporate social, the impact are the same. We don't have to differentiate between these two. Now, when we talk about the impact of corporate social responsibility or corporate social investment, it promotes the customer's loyalty. Customers will be loyal to that particular business or company. Let's take, for example, as an enterprise, you came up with a project whereby, let's say at our school, there are learners who were attending school. So now maybe they are there at the location, they are unemployed. Then you come up with a criteria, those learners who've got a particular 60% or more, you train them, you give them a particular skill so that they be able to become the entrepreneur. For rendering or for doing that project, then customers will be loyal to that enterprise, because you are an enterprise that is seen that you are taking care of what? Of your community, because you are rendering those particular projects. And second point, this project, they promote teamwork in a working environment. If you're going to do this project and come up with a system of training, it will promote teamwork in the business environment. And then the business, they're going to enjoy a good will, or they're going to have a good image. Public, it will perceive that enterprise as an enterprise that is doing well, because you are taking care of the community. The other point, the fourth point, is that corporate social investment, guys, it's going to attract the investors. The investor would like to invest in this type of a project that takes care of the community.
Yeah, well, I'm investing.
And then it will improve the health of its employees through these projects. And it will assist in solving the challenges that we have as a country of socioeconomic issues. You know, we've got this challenge, socioeconomic HIV, unemployment, poverty. When you are going to do this project as an enterprise, you'll be alleviating, you'll be minimizing those challenges. You'll be assisting the community by minimizing those socioeconomic issues. And then the other point, that the impact, is that It will give business tax advantage or reduction or rebate. Now, what is happening? If you're an enterprise and then you've made a particular profit, therefore you're supposed to disclose that profit to SARS. Therefore, SARS is going to determine how much tax you're supposed to pay as an enterprise. And if you're an enterprise who is doing this project, therefore your tax is going to be low. That we call tax rebate or tax reduction, because you are seen as an enterprise who's doing corporate social investment, corporate social responsibility. Therefore, now I would like us to talk about the disadvantages of corporate social investment, corporate social responsibility. That is, what is bad about this?
Negative.
What is bad is that at times a community, they feel that they are entitled. As an enterprise, we suppose they're used to this particular project. So now they feel, let's take for example, at our school, usually we've got feeding scheme where the government make sure that each learner who's got a problem at home, by the day, you'll be having at least a meal. They are sure of that. So now you'll find the parents, now they don't want to give a lunch money to these kids. Go to school. You know most you're going to get food there. It's the responsibility of a parent to ensure that her child or his child eats. So now if you don't want to give lunch money to your kids because of this project that are initiated by the government, it's not your right. So now, at times, the community become dependent to this project. The second point, it is difficult to be sure that this project is effective.
Was it a success?
To test or to check the effectiveness of this project, it's not easy. And then, at times, this project are conducted by the people who are not trained. That is why some of this project, they are not sustained, because one is not trained, doesn't know how to conduct that particular project. And the other thing, it diverts or it changes the aim of the business. For example, let's take any enterprise, their objective is to just make profit. Now, if they do this project, that project, it will be out of the objectives of the business. So some profits of the business, it is used to do this project. So if the investor invested in that enterprise, therefore the dividends, they will be less because some of the profit, it is used to do this project rather than taking all of the profit and give it to the shareholders. And the other point is that this may feel that this project are not supported. At times you came with a particular project that is supposed to be supported. Maybe the customers come and buy that, but if the customers, they don't buy, therefore that project won't be sustained. And small, medium enterprises, they fail. They don't have enough profit. They cannot do this project. Only the bigger companies got enough funds, and that is all. And now I would like us to talk about the impact of corporate social investment on communities. Now, we were talking about the business context now. Now, on community, the positive things, community skills can be uplifted because you're going to give bursaries. Therefore, the kids of that community can find bursaries to uplift their life. Better educational facilities can be established for poor communities. Second point. The third point, the better standard of living. Because you're doing this project, the standard of living can become better for that particular community. Investing in a medical infrastructure will improve the health of that communities. Socioeconomic issues can be attended to and can be minimized for that particular community. And training opportunities in the community can increase. Appointment or jobs can be created because of this training that are implemented by the business. Those are the advantages in terms of corporate social investment, corporate social responsibility on communities. Now let's talk about the disadvantages now. Businesses are not always equipped to address. They don't know how to do it. They don't know how to render those projects. because they started that business for a particular objective, not for that reason to conduct those objectives. And then communities tend to be dependent, as I've said it somewhere, that they tend to be dependent. People will divorce their objectives and depend on the business. Ah, you are going to be given a food parcel, they go there. And the business tend to focus on the programs that not directly benefit the community at times. They're just going to do that project because they know the tax rate is going to be less. Just do a project, Jay. That's not going to assist the community. And the other point, businesses cannot meet the long-term needs of the community. Long-term needs, they cannot sustain that project for a longer period because to conduct that project, it means money for the business. And then less money is available for community projects during unfavorable economic conditions. If the economic conditions of the country, they are not well, so it is impossible for the business to render such projects. And now I would like you, after we've done this, I would like us to do the assessment on page 4, whereby we are going to be assessed in terms of corporate social responsibility, the assessment to check the level of your understanding there. When we talk about corporate social investment, it's when the business commits its money, its resources, and time on a particular project. You know, the business, they decide on themselves. They are not forced by law to do this project. So now the business will choose whether let us do HIV and AIDS, or let us do unemployment, or let us uplift this. It will be the choice of an enterprise to do the project. And then the projects are not directly for the purpose of increasing the profit of the business. No, they're just designed to uplift just the community. And then this project, they've got a strong approach on how the business is going to use or how they're going to utilize their resources. Now, the purpose of corporate social investment, their aim is to contribute a sustainable, continuous program that's not going to end, that will help the community. The other point, corporate social investment, it is enforceable by law and government that requires the business to make this project. It is a lawful conduct. You will be seen as an enterprise that's doing a lawful conduct if you are doing this project. And then the third point, the project play a positive role in developing the community.
Positive, positive, positive. Up!
And then the fourth point, corporate social investment reveals the business attitude towards community. It shows that this enterprise, they focus on community by doing this project because they do those projects. So they take care of that community. Now, corporate social investment, it is seen as a long-term investment for an enterprise.
That's a long-term investment.
Investment on which sense? Let's take, for example, Impala Platinum, that enterprise. They've got project that they're rendering it at school, particularly for the learners who are doing math and science. They upskill, they give classes, they give tests, they do what. They know that they're investing in the long run. When they want people who were trained in terms of math and science, they can go back to their records and check their registers and find those learners that they've trained in terms of math and science. So it is a long-term investment in that sense. So now we've got focus areas of corporate social investment. They are four. That is community, rural development, employees, and environment. Then we've got the examples of corporate social investment projects. what type of projects that can be conducted by these different businesses. They can do what? They can donate to support local organization. Donations can be done. They can become involved in conservation projects, take care of the environment. They can deliver service that the government is unable to deliver, infrastructure, maybe come and fix the roads or do what. They can do that as a business. They can invest in job creation projects. They can provide adult basic education. They can do that. They can teach entrepreneurial skills where people can open their own businesses because of the learning that they've acquired from those projects. They can sponsor arts and culture programs. Those are the examples of projects that can be done by the enterprise. Now, I would like us to talk about the differences between the two.
Different.
You will be asked these differences. So now, if you are expected to give differences, you're supposed to put them in a table form. Yeah? Now, the difference between corporate social investment and corporate social responsibility. So on the other side, you write CSR. On the other side, you write CSI, corporate social investment. Now, the first difference that we will talk about under corporate social responsibility, the intention is to change the business practices. When you are doing corporate social, you want to change the business practices. And on corporate social investment, they are just focusing to uplift community. The projects are initiated to ensure that they uplift the community. And then the other point, it focuses on increasing the image and the profit, corporate social responsibility. They want to increase the image and the profits of the business, whereas on the other side, they are focusing at uplifting the community without a return, without profits. They're not focusing on the profit. They just want to assist this, to uplift this community. Then the third difference. It can be used as a marketing strategy, marketing initiative, marketing it to advertise. When you are doing corporate social responsibility, you can use that as an advertising campaign. Whereas when you are doing corporate social investment, it's not. It is intending to uplift the social development of this community. Now, these are the differences that you would find. Therefore, on page 5, I would like you to do this assessment. Please subscribe to our videos so that we can be able to be sustained in our videos. Thank you very much.